Hi everyone.
Hey everybody.
I am currently getting my fourth chemo treatment. I'll show you what it looks like. So everybody has to wear masks, of course. And this is what they call a port that has the, it's rather than having to put it in my arm, they put it directly into a vein. So the port is inside and they do a needle in there. So they make sure that it doesn't clot when I first get here. And then they bring me upstairs for the infusion. So again, this is my fourth infusion. I have been unclear about something in my blogs, and I want to explain something for my cancer. The kind of cancer I have is called HER2 positive, and it, some people call it aggressive, some people don't, so I don't know if that's really true, but it's the kind of cancer that can spread. And so they are giving me a year's worth of chemo. That's the big way, easy way to say it. Let me break that down. So what they decided to do is to give me six treatments that they call the napalm bomb of chemo to kill any kind of fast multiplying stuff inside of me, including hair follicles. Six treatments, 3 weeks apart, will be done in June. So I have finished, right now I'm finishing my fourth treatment. So I have to get over the side effects of this, but my fourth treatment, I will be waiting on the two last napalm bombs and chemo. Then I have my surgery, where they're going to do a double mastectomy. And then they're also, it's a tummy tuck. So they take the fat from your stomach and they use it for your
reconstruction.
So it's nice because it's your own body. And I'll have to recover from that. But right after that, they're going to start me again on
immunotherapy.
Two immunotherapies called Herceptin and Perjeta that I have already been on since I started in March 5th. So I'm going to be doing that for a full year.
So until next March.
So after my surgery this summer, I will recover for a little bit, and then I will start the immunotherapy is really what they call it, targeted immunotherapy. And the way the nurse explained it to me today is that it finds exactly my kind of cancer and kills it, rather than just trying to kill anything that could be.
It's a little more, specific. And so then starting in August, probably we will be driving back and forth to Seattle, same as we are now, every 3 weeks.
So
till March.
That's our update. I am doing well. I am doing pretty much as well as can be expected on chemo. I'm starting to sleep a lot. My white blood cells and my red blood cells are quite low, so I'm very tired and anemic.
Hi everybody.
It's so good that you guys are still interested, and really appreciate your care and your support. I also want to do a shout out for my blog. If you are interested, find my blog. I'm blogging here pretty much
every day.
And Shane does once a week when I don't feel very well. And we just want to tell you guys that we are very loved and that we are very grateful for your kindness and for your support and for your encouragement online. And with all that you're going through, we are very blessed.
Yeah.
To have such a
great group of people surrounding us. We couldn't do it without you guys. I don't know if you haven't read our blog, but this is one of the biggest challenges I've ever faced in my life, and a big thank you, big thank you to
Hi Brent.
Hey Brent. Hi Chuck. to Paula and Steve Rains, because, man, they have opened up their home and
we
their
lives.
We
have been there probably 3 weeks
out of the
total
last.
So far. Yeah, lots
so
of days.
Just,
thank you guys.
It's been amazing, and without it, because of the
hi,
COVID
Jay.
Thing, it would be really hard for us to
hi,
stay
Alan.
Anywhere. Hi, Lisa.
Hi, Lisa.
So, and again, hi, Ron.
Alan. Hi, Jessica. Oh, hi, Ronnie.
Hi, Angela.
Hi, Angela and Karen and Lori and Monica and Chuck. Thank you. Love back at you. Keep playing music, man. Hi, Mark and Kathy and Jay and Amanda. Valuable Valley. Okay.
Don.
Hi,
Don. Hi,
Don. So,
I have something to say.
Go ahead.
So,
I have one more thing. Chemo brain is a real thing.
So. It's a real thing. But I have always teased Shannon and her sister and her siblings that the Hugheses, they like to sleep. They can sleep a lot, okay? But since I met Shannon over the last several years, she hasn't slept very much. But she can go to sleep at 8 or 9, sleep till 7, be up for a couple hours, sleep for another 2.5, be up for an hour, sleep for another 2. So it's pretty interesting to watch this process.
Thanks. I'm glad you like my hair. I got 4 wigs from Amazon, all under $25. This is my celebration. I have a new dress on as well. My celebration from my halfway point. So my halfway point of the harsh chemo. And if that is interesting to you, feel free to go back to the beginning and see how I explained it. Hope I explained it clearly.
She did, yeah.
And so the hardest part is the alternating between the diarrhea and the constipation. My nose sores. My mucous membranes ache next week. Anything that has that's the worst part. And
this bake it, no energy.
No energy. So I need to exercise. Yes, I loved your bird posts. So there was a sweet, sweet post that Jay did about a little bird that the other birds had pecked and she was bald. But she had a bird that fell in love with her and protected her from the other birds.
Are you saying I'm a bird?
Yeah. You're my fine feathered friend. Hi, Mindy. So anyway, I'll show you one more thing, because this is the view. We are very blessed. Look, this is not our view from home. Obviously, we're in Seattle,
from the chemo room.
I hope you can see it. Can they see?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So. Thank you for taking the time. Thank you, Monica. Hi, Tim. Hi, Jeannie. Thank you for taking the time to listen to our update and follow my blog. We are coming up on 15,000 views on my blog in the last 65 posts. And so we are grateful for that you're interested, and we're grateful to be able to share our love and our what we're gleaning from this cancer journey, and we are
learning a lot.
We're growing a lot.
Okay,
and
and the love is stronger.
Okay,
which is really cool.
Yeah. So, anybody has questions, you feel free to ask. We're pretty much an open book. So, if you have any friends or anybody that you want to support that's going through something like this, we're always willing to answer questions.
Hi, Katie. Hi, Lexi. Hi, Marnie. Hi, Mark. That's all. So it's been a while since we did an update, so thank you, and we will talk to you again soon.
You guys all have a great day.
Subscribe. subscribe to my blog. Find it.